So hello friends, welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demonstration on AVR based microcontroller development platform. The complete trainer kit is designed for performing the basic operations of development on the microcontroller AVR segment, as we have provided a microcontroller 8 mega series 8515 family, so that you can easily create your own codes on the complete development form. The modules are optional, which are also we provide in this complete setup, so you can use them for finding out the different programming, how the AVR chips works. In this video we will be see the complete communication of the AVR platform with the PC, how the software will be used for burning the hex files in the complete microchip, and how we can erase this, and some few settings we will be also watching it in this video. So now we move on to the complete kit description. All the parts I will be explaining in this video one by one, and then we will be do the basic hex file program on the microchip controller. So this is the complete setup and accessories of the AVR microcontroller development platform. The order code is 19204141.31. You can use this order code to find out all the specification. The order code will be also available in the kit and the video description also, and the complete all the blocks will be explained in this video later. The manual for the complete working of this trainer board is provided, in which you can study the complete microcontroller working theory. All the chip diagrams, circuit diagrams are provided in this. The power supply is also provided, so you can easily provide power supply, which is an SMPS power supply, so that all the different type of power supply is provided from the SMPS separately. USB cable is also provided for the programming using the Khazama AVR programmer, which is provided with the software content of this complete setup. 10-pin FRC for connecting the ISP header programmer section to the controller section. Some patch codes for the accessories for doing the complete connections of the microcontroller modules and some others. So I will explain you the basic component parts of complete trainer board. Later on we will see the communication with the PC and we will burn some hex files and some flash memories on the microchip for a sample. So this is the closer look of this complete development platform, in which we will start with the section 1. In the section 1, it is a DC power supply section, in which onboard plus 12 volt, minus 12 volt, plus 5 volts and minus 5 volts supplies are available for students for making their circuit and perform an experiment and by their desired. In the section 2, we have a main part of this development platform, which provides microcontroller's DIF socket. 0 insertion 4 socket is provided with the 40 pin supports. Reset block, in which we can hard reset the microcontroller after programming or while programming it. And the crystal block is also provided, which provides about 8 MHz of crystal frequency with this XTEL 2 terminal. And XTEL 1 and XTEL 2 terminals are also provided, so that we can easily provide any external crystal frequency also. Port connections for breadboard are also provided, port A, B, C and D of the microcontroller. Port connector for FRCs are also provided on the development board, so that you can easily connect any other module while performing the program also. This is the ground selections and ground test pins. Port A connector details are given in the user manual as well. I will also explain you it on the front panel. The pin 1 and 2 are of the PH0. Similarly, pin 3 and 4 of the microcontroller is a PA1, pin 5 and 6 for PA2, pin number 7 and 8 for PA3. Similarly, go on, pin number 19, 20 is for ground, and pin number 17, 18 is for the VCC is given over here. Similarly, all the details of all the ports are given. You can see them in the user manual. Details about the all pins are given, so that you can use all the ports as per your requirement while programming and developing your codes. Similarly, all the ports are provided for breadboard supplies also. The bread supply, DC supply, is also provided on the budget strip pin on the breadboard. You can connect all the supplies regarding the supply terminals and supply buses, the whatever supply you want to use, ground with the plus 5, minus 5, plus 12 and minus 12 volt supplies. All the four supplies are provided on the nearboard registry pin slot for the breadboard also. And all the ports, port A, B, C and D are also provided, so that easily port input output IO selections are can be easily provided on any of the IC for the programming and execution of the program that you are going to develop in the microchip. In the section 3, it is a microcontroller programmer unit in which one USB connector is given for the programming in the right side of the development platform. Over here we will see it on the developing and the communication section as well. Two ISP connectors are given for the connecting programmer to microcontroller. These are the ISP header that I have explained earlier. We need a 10 pin FRC cable for connecting them both, and two LEDs are also provided for supply indication and other for the busy during programming, and the on off socket or the on off toggle switch also provided, so that you can on and off the programmer wherever you want to do programming. ISP stands for in system programming. This is a mechanism by which Atmel AVR microcontroller can be programmed in situ at same location without physically removing them from the target system. This type of programming can be usually be programmed and performed at per the target system VCC voltage with no requirement for higher VPP voltage to be applied to the devices during programming. ISP protocols defined by 3 pins, which are SCA serial clock, MISO, MISO and MOSI, master clock output, slave clock input for SPI pin, master data input, slave data output and SPI master data output and slave data input. All the programming description and details are also given in the user manual. You can follow them and study the complete microcontroller AVR platform and about the microcontroller in detail by studying the user manual. So this is all about the complete kit description or the microcontroller description. All the detailed studies can be done using the referring the user manual. Now we move on to the software installation by which we can program this and by which we can perform and flash the buffer in the microcontroller chip or the ROM memories, and also we will see how we set up the complete development platform with the power supply and the USB connectors. Now firstly we will connect the power cord on the front terminal sockets for connecting it to the 220 volt AC power supply, and the output terminal of this SMPS supply will be connected on the left side of this development trainer board. Carefully align the connector and push it inside it and turn the SMPS on. And as the SMPS turned on, you can see the power indication of the development platform is also on. You can measure all the voltage using a DMM for checking up your proper supply is connected or not. Now after that, the USB for programming it with the PC, you need to connect it on the rightmost side for the microcontroller. Over here you can connect the USB for programming. Just carefully insert the USB on the right side. The slot is provided. After installing and connecting the USB, the other end of this USB cable will be connected with the PC. Now we move on to the software installation. Connect this USB with the PC, and we will also install the USB driver in the PC, and then we will see the programming of the microcontroller. So after opening the CD or the CD material in your PC, you will find these folders inside the CD, and here you will find the software folder. So we'll now ready to install the programmer software, which is our Cosma AVR programmer. So it is in zip form. If you find it in zip form, you can unzip it easily, and then this is the file inside it that need to be installed. This is the setup file, so we'll double click on it and we'll install the Cosma AVR programmer. Click on the launch icon if you want to launch the AVR programmer. Here the programmer is launched. If the USB drivers are installed, this will find out the connected kit
with this. But if the USB drivers are not installed, this will be blank after opening it. Now I will explain you how to install the USB driver for this. Now for installing the device software or the driver, we will just need to connect the USB through TrainerKit to PC. So as I connected the cable, we will see a message on the toolbar, and if the message is not seen on the toolbar, we can just directly open the device manager. Here we will find USB ASP, is it not in the other driver devices? So we need to set up a driver for this. So we'll right click on its update driver, browse from my computer drivers and select the position at where the CD folder is open. So we go to desktop for this, as our Microtech C training kit folder is at the desktop right now. Here we will select from softwares and in driver folder, as my PC is of 64-bit, so I am using the library USB. You can select any of the library, whether it is 0.1.12.1 or 1.2.4.0. So as we select the library folder, press OK and press next. It will ask you to publish the driver software, install software anyway, and the window has successfully updated your driver's USB ASP. Now we can see the driver is not anymore in the other devices, it's now readable as library USB to Win32 devices USB ASP drivers. So as the driver is now installed, we can open the Kazma again, the programmer, and there we will find out the read chip signature. And as I press the read chip signature, this will read the signature of the chip and give us output as any of the value. So this is our signature of the chip. Now we are ready to program the AVR trainer board. Now for selecting the device that is connected on our trainer kit, we will go to file, open AVR and open Mega, in which we have to select 8515, which is our chip which is connected on the trainer board right now. So we'll select this. Here AVR is now selected as Atmega 8515. Here different type of Atmega chips are provided, so at whichever chip you are working, you can select any of them. For this instance, the 8515 is our chip. Now it is ready to program.
Now after installing the software and the communication with the complete trainer board, now we can check the basic things on the development platform. So first we will check the power supply of the DC supply unit, then we'll check the power supply and all the points of the ports as well. So first we'll connect the digital multimeter. You can use any available digital multimeter for checking the supply on that. So first we will connect it to the 12 volt. So we first set the multimeters to the DC measurement, DC voltage measurement. Here you can see the voltage is 12 volts in the positive. Then we have plus 5 volts. Then we have minus 12 volts. A slight minus indications is also given in the use multimeters, and the minus 5 volts also. So these are the available supplies on this. Also we can check the reset key of the development platform as well. Connect the multimeter on the ground, and on the reset test point you can check the voltage is about 5 volts. So as I press reset, the voltage goes drop, and as I release the reset push button, it's again go up to the 5 volts supply. So this is how reset is working. Now we will check, first empty the complete chip and clean it, erase it with the software, and we will see the voltages on all the ports pin. Now for programming it, the microchip controller, for erasing or doing any of the optional and options and the operations using the programmer, you just need to connect the ISP header programmer with the controller using this 10-pin FRC cable. Now this is connected, programmer and controller is now connected with each other. Now we can do the erasing of the chip. First we will see the blank chip voltages and later we will see the voltages change after the programming.
Now for downloading the program, or after downloading the program in the AVR, now you can erase the AVR, or before checking the voltage for AVR, just go to command menu. Over here you will see the erase chip option and you can directly press the control R also. So erasing the chip will erase all the program inside the AVR. So we'll erase the IC. Right now the programmer is not connected again, so we'll turn it on and erase the chip. Are you want to show erase chip? It will ask you for the yes or no. Press yes and your chip will be erased. This message is shown on the right screen, right bottom.
Now after erasing the chip from the programmer, now we can check the voltages on all the terminals of the ports. So here we can see the voltages are quite low and quite very less in value. Check all the ports one by one. You can also write down all the voltages. Here the volts near about 0.2 or 0.1 volts. These are the unprogrammed chips, unprogrammed pins. So in this port the voltage will be always high. This is the port C, and on the other port the voltages are very low. Similarly, now we flash a memory buffer in the microchip and then after we will check the again ports voltages. It will define us the port voltages will have some values and this will give us the programmed chip, and we can show that the chip is programmed according to the port values.
For downloading the program in the microcontroller development platform, you just need to open the Cosmo AVR programmer as described in this window and go to file menu. Over here go to load file flash buffer, open this, go to your CD folder at which location the folder is installed, go to main input and in which the folder MCXX codes for modules are provided. So these are some basic codes for different modules that is provided with the complete trainer board. Use the modules, you can take them the modules from the optional and open any of the module code. This is the hex file that you need to burn on the microcontroller chip. Select this and now go to command and go to write flash buffer to chip. Write it here. The USB is not connected right now, so we'll turn on the USB programmer again and again perform the option write flash buffer to chip. Here you can see a bar will be indicating that the flash writing, and after that you will get a message which is flash write OK. So our flash or the 8 mega IC is now programmed. We can check the output voltages on the trainer.
So now after writing the flash in the chip or the microcontroller, now we can again check the voltages on some of the ports. The voltage may be different from the earlier ones. Now again we connect the multimeter to ground and at the port 1 over here you can see the voltages right now 2.5 volts. In the earlier case, the voltage is about the 0.1 volts. So that's how the ports are programmed for giving the and taking input output for the microcontroller chip. And as per the program selection and as per the programming, the ports have the different voltages values right now on the microcontroller chip. Take down all the port values, port pins values. Similarly, on the other hand, the voltages of the ports will be depend as per the program code which is right on the microchip. So there will be always different voltages for the different programming sections. Also, for the external clock, you can use the external terminals, or either if you want to provide any external clock as per your chip for the AVR programming, you can connect the any external function generator for the external clock of the programming at which you want to do your program and development of the microchip at the external one, and on the external two you will get the required generated pulse on the external two. So connect the function generator on the external two terminal directly, whatever the clock or the external clock at which you want to do the programming. Till then, there is an internal 8 MHz oscillator is provided. So we'll use a DSO or CRO for checking the external pulse on the external terminal. So this is how, as I described in the software, you can program the codes for your own development and as well as some modules which is optional, which the codes are provided with the complete trainer setup. So you can purchase the optional module so that you can connect them on the required port as described, and you can do the programming on the microchip and see them operating with the microcontroller development platform. So here our demonstration of this AVR microcontroller development platform is now completed. As I described in this video, you can communicate this complete development platform with the PC using the Kazuma AVR programmer. You can download your hex files on the microchip. And if you have the modules are right now not provided with this kit and not described in this video section also. We will extend the video when we get the modules section and modules requirement also. So when the modules is connected, you can do programming as per the module. Codes are already given in the user manual and with the software CD, so that you can download the different module codes and see the programming, how the modules are operated according to the AVR program. So still you find will difficulties while working with this kit, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. And if you like the video and get some knowledge about the AVR programming, some basic concepts of yours got cleared with this video, you can like this video on the YouTube, and also you can share this video to your friends, to your colleagues, to your classmates, those who want to learn about the AVR programming and development of the AVR microcontrollers. Also, you can subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of videos with different types of development platform. Also, different type of educational trainers are uploaded. You can go there and study the different type of practical experiences on the YouTube channel Tesca Tech. Also, don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video with a new trainer, with a new technology, you can get the notification about that as well and got to learn about them also. Thank you for watching this video. We'll meet in the next video very soon.